I know I can't go wherever the wind blows. This much I do know. Though darkness may blind you, I'll come and find you. You know that it's so. And when I'm lonely, you are the only answer I see. And when I'm weary, whenever you're near me, I know that I am free.
I maybe need to start my everyday like that. Good morning, everyone. I'm Karen Gonzalez, Director of Faith Development here at River of Grass. My pronouns are she, her, and I live on the ancestral lands of the Tequesta tribe, later settled upon by Seminoles. Welcome to our love-streamed service of the River of Grass Unitarian Universalist Congregation of Davie, Florida, where we continue to meet here online to keep one another and our community safe in the midst of the COVID-19 virus. In this congregation, it is our mission to nurture our spirits, love intentionally, and create a just and healthy planet in our enduring search for truth, meaning, and faith. What we share here is not an unchanging dogma, but a call to be agents of love and justice to transform ourselves and our world. Our mission has not changed, and this time the world seems to have tilted on its axis, nor are our connections weakened, but all the more a brilliant flame lighting our way. We welcome you this morning, whoever you are, wherever you are, as you are, and join our journey with yours as we breathe into this moment together. This morning, as we continue to explore what it means to be a people of story, we begin with these words from the Reverend Dr. David Breeden from their work entitled, A Day Unwritten, read by this year's Faith Development Teaching Team. Welcome to a new story.
Welcome to a day unwritten.
We gather to speak of possibility.
We remember the losses.
We celebrate the victories.
As a people of story,
we embrace the possible
over the probable.
Weaving a story of hope.
Join us in a new story.
Join us in the day unwritten.
Join us in the future of possibility.
Let there be lights, the light of joy, the light of happiness, and the light of contentment. May illuminate our paths and fill our lives with peace. And let there be dark, for it is from our dark places that we are brought forward, tried and tested and impelled towards growth. It is in these places that we realize compassion and learn to love. And there was day, and there was night, and there was joy, and there was sorrow, and it was good.
In the light of love, let us renew our covenant, as we say together. Love is the spirit of this congregation, and service is its law. This is our great covenant, to dwell together in peace, to seek truth and love, and to help one another.
El amor es el espíritu de esta congregación y el servicio su ley principal. Esta es nuestra gran promesa, vivir juntos en paz, buscar la verdad a través del amor y ayudarnos mutuamente.
For all that. At River of Grass, we offer so many ways to live our Unitarian Universalist faith in action. You'll find them in our weekly email, on our Facebook page, and on our website. Our website is River of Grass UU. Don't forget that, UU, riverofgrassuu.org. Here are some upcoming opportunities to fulfill the mission and vision of this congregation in this time and in this place, and other announcements for the life of this beloved community. Let's see, what do we have? Today, our children and youth will be celebrating the end of the school year with a game day. We have fun online and group games, online games and group games. Both kinds are planned and we are open to more. So bring your games and your giggles. See, we make one another laugh. Bring your giggles with you. Also, don't forget to send in your videos and photos for our flower ceremony, which is next week. So here's how you make the video. You start with a flower or a leaf or something you love over here off camera.
Where are you going?
To the right. Mm-hmm. And then you bring it to yourself and you appreciate it.
Where are you going?
And then you pass it to the left. Okay, so you come from your right across the screen and to your left, right? Take as much time as you want. Or if you want to just send a still photograph or any other video showing the beauty that's around you, flowers that you love, the beauty and the uniqueness that you bring each and all, feel free to do that. Send them to minister@riverofgrassuu.org. Minister, that's me, @riverofgrassuu.org, and watch the magic. In our community, each week we share pieces of our lives. This has taken a new form as well in this pandemic year where we have been online now for, 16 months? Our connections are not lessened in this. We've made a way using this technology to use chat to share our joys and concerns on a Sunday morning. So if there's something you would like to bring into this circle of concern, into this circle of care in this community, a shot, a prayer, a thought, joy or concern, put it in the chat and we will lift it up here together. It is something that we can hold together, both the joys and the sorrows in our same moments share, that we can multiply the joys with sharing and lighten our burdens with sharing. It's a remarkable gift of community that this can happen in this place. That we can do it, that we can journey with one another, whatever comes our way. Let us hold a moment of silence for these things that have been shared and remembering those things that may not have been given voice, but are no less real in our hearts. Source of all we call upon in times of joy and times of trouble. By whatever name our hearts may speak, none of which we can ever fully know. We bring these things written and unwritten, spoken and unspoken. We know that we are learning to see hearts even as we become more willing to have our own hearts seen. May we be a people so brave and so bold and so caring. May we ever widen the circle of our concern and the circle of our care. May we ever bring into our midst those in need of support or those so eager to share what they have discovered in their lives. We're grateful for the milestones met. We're mindful of those who need healing this morning in body or in spirit. We ask that the falls stop. We ask that we surround one another with care, with vigilance, that we surround one another with thought, that we constantly lift up one another and also be willing to ask for help when we ourselves may need it. We remember that in the world, we have milestones also this weekend. We remember the people of Tulsa. We remember the loss there. We ask for reparations there. We remember those who gave all in our wars that we might still celebrate our freedoms to be even here this morning. We are grateful for those who chose to serve and gave their all. All these things we lift in the name of all that is holy. Amen, amen, amin, aho, ashe, namaste. Blessed be. And so it is. Another thing we like to do here is show gratitude for those who make this river go and grow and flow. This morning, on Faith Development Sunday, we offer thanks for our teachers and for our families and all the youngins that show up in screens and throughout a year that's been difficult and trying and also a year of exploration and ingenuity. And that ingenuity has come so fiercely from our Director of Faith Development, Karen Gonzalez. Karen, we have no idea what we would do without you. We had no clue when we started, neither did you, of the gifts you would bring in this year of creative thinking and the efforts you have gone to sustain our families and keep our children growing in the ways of Unitarian Universalism is unparalleled. We are so, so grateful. All of our families for you, our entire congregation for you, and I am grateful for you and proud to serve alongside as we collaborate in this shared ministry. Thank you. Diane?
Good morning. Hi, I'm Diane Lade, and I am a proud faith development teacher and also the chair of our Faith Development Committee. Here's some words that I wish I would have written, but actually they come from the journalist and author Graham Greene. And they are, there is always one moment in childhood when the door opens and lets in the future. Those words were on a card that our Faith Development Committee gave to Karen several years ago, pre-pandemic. That was a time when we had classrooms and in-person holiday gatherings and outings to the park and hugs and kids up on the stage. And of course, our world looks pretty different right now. But, you know, in some ways, it looks even better.
Yeah.
Sometimes a crisis can do that, especially when you are lucky enough to have someone like Karen Gonzalez leading your faith development program, which is faith development for all of us, especially the way that Karen structures it. It's definitely for the children, for the teens, for the families, but it's for adults. It's for the congregation. At River of Grass, faith development is what we do, and we do it for everyone. So when that door that Graham Greene talks about, and that door had to open for our future. Boy, Karen opened that door and she opened it wide. So Karen, today for you, all of us, light a candle for you in appreciation. Thank you.
We have a treat for you, Karen.
Thank you. a year and a half ago, we, the members of the River of Grass, voted unanimously to begin a search for a new home. At that time, we thought about $1.5 million would be what we would need. In October this past year, we launched a capital campaign in order to raise this amount. Now, in the meantime, throughout this past year, our future home search team has been looking for a suitable site. And we learned that commercial property market has been on an upswing. And we estimate that we will need over $2 million. We currently have about $1.1 million available, with another $0.3 million in unpaid pledges, giving us potentially $1.4 million. This means there is a potential shortfall of about $500,000 or more. So, at our annual meeting, May 16th, a new pledge campaign was launched. This is our drive to the future. We are asking our members and friends to again look at their finance to determine if they can make a new pledge or increase the pledge that they already made. And we have this wonderful, generous donor who has agreed to match any new and increased pledge of $3,000 or more. So your donation has a potential of actually doubling to our goal. All donations and pledges in any amount are welcome. The more we can raise, the less we will have to finance. So please give generously. Go to our website, riverofgrassuu.org, scroll down to the information about our drive to the future, and click on the link to make your pledge or donation. Thank you.
We sustain and strengthen this beloved community and its mission in our world through the gifts of our time and skills, our love and laughter, and our money. Each Sunday, half of our undesignated offerings go to LifeNet for Families, which provides hot meals, clothing, and support here in Broward County. The other half supports the mission and ministries of River of Grass. This sharing practice is more crucial than ever in this tumultuous time, and we are grateful to report that your generosity is making it possible for us to increase our support for those in need in our community and in our congregation. In this time, we continue to gather virtually to keep one another safe. We have centralized several ways to give on our River of Grass website at the link you see on the screen and in the chat. If you like using text to give, you can still do that. If you're accustomed to putting a regular amount in the basket, you can do that now digitally on our donate webpage, either by using the donate button or contact our office to set up automatic donation for your convenience. Whatever method works best for you, please give generously and joyfully that we may feed and fortify this congregation and its good work in the world.
Once upon a time, there was a man with a story. This wasn't any old once upon a time story, not one you could find on a bookshelf or hear around the campfire. This was his story, and no one else's. This story had been carefully crafted. It began before he was born, and this story told of his loves and his fears, his dreams realized, and his dreams yet to come. The story was complete. It told his whole life, including those bits that still existed only in his imagination. In fact, this story was so complete and he was so happy with his story that he carried it around to make sure it was safe. It was somewhat bulky and unwieldy, but he didn't mind. It was his story. The thing about this story was, it was very fragile, made up of tiny pieces and held together by only his own imagination. Made up of many pieces and held together by only his own imagination. He was worried it might break apart at any minute, and so he grew more and more protective of his story. He held it even closer. As he went about his life, he checked on the story to make sure he was following it correctly. He avoided adventure and unknowns because, well, they might break his story. And then one day, the inevitable happened. Without warning, his story broke. It was unforeseen, and he hadn't done anything wrong at all. But there it was, laying in 1,000 shattered pieces on the ground, with the sunlight glinting off the bits of story he had so carefully protected for all those years. He was heartbroken. And since his story hadn't said to put the pieces back together, he was at a loss. What now? He sat down next to the pile of pieces and cried. A while later, maybe it was minutes, maybe it was hours, a group of people came out of the nearby building and saw him sitting on the sidewalk, surrounded by a pile of broken pieces, clearly in need of help. "What happened here?" a woman asked. "My story. It's gone. I worked so hard to build it, to protect it, to keep it from harm, and now it's gone, gone!" he wailed. "Is this a story here?" a man asked. "Yes, look at it. There's nothing left of it." "It looks like it's here, not gone," said a child. "We just have to put it back together." "Put it back together? There's no way. You don't even know what it looked like. How will you put it back together if you don't even know me?" The child was tenacious. "Don't worry. With all of us here to help, we'll put it back together in a way that you would never even expect. You know, it might be more beautiful than it was before." And so they swept up the pieces of this man's story carefully and went together into the building from which they had emerged. They poured him some hot coffee and sang a song he had never heard before. Something about coming again and again, though you've broken your vows 1,000 times. The song was soothing and the coffee was warm. He began to feel hope again, that his story could be put back together. And it took a long time. Maybe it was days, maybe it was years, but they all got it. They got it all put back together and they added new parts, and some old parts didn't fit anymore, but that was okay. The child had been right. It was more beautiful than before. And this time, the story was held together not only by his imagination, but by the imagination and support of an entire community. It wasn't nearly so fragile anymore. And it even allowed for adventure. The end?
In a moment, I will invite you to join in singing "Come, Come, Whoever You Are." The text is from Mevlana Jalaluddin Rumi, who was a 13th century Muslim theologian, scholar, and Sufi mystic. He was born in modern-day Afghanistan from Persian-speaking parents and lived most of his life in the Anatolian Peninsula, which is where modern-day Turkey is. He was a lifelong scholar of the Quran and Islam. We are singing it today, including the crucial descant, "Though you've broken your vows 1,000 times." thereby welcoming ourselves and each other as we are, with our failings and shortcomings, again and again turning back toward joy and belonging. Though you've broken your vows a thousand times, 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 come, come, whoever you are, wanderer, worshiper, lover of leaving, ours is no caravan of despair. Come yet again, come. Come, come, whoever you are, wanderer, come, whoever you are. Ours is no caravan, lover you are. Ours is no caravan, lover you are. Ours is no caravan, lover you are. Cause is no cash again, lover is moving. 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 Cause is no cash again, cough to spare. Cock in your yet again, comes and cock in your vest again, thousand times. Though you've cock in your vest again, thousand times. Come yet again, come.
Just so you know, that earlier piece with the thank you didn't go the way I had it in the script. My script said something like this. Today, we thank our River of Grass teachers and the Faith Development Committee for the gift of their time, their talent, and their love, so generously given to the cause of growing our Unitarian Universalist faith in the hearts and minds of our youngest in our community. We are all the better for your service, so we thank you. And before I begin this morning's message, I'd like to acknowledge the music makers in today's service. I do believe this was our first kazoo choir. Thank you, Rev Amy, for that magic, along with Emmy, Everett, Alex, Aurora, Haley, and Elena. And another shout out to our visiting musician, Louisa Wimberger, longtime friend from our Southeastern Unitarian Universalist Summer Institute, where she makes lots of beautiful music. You'll see her later in the service, along with many bubble makers. In this morning's wisdom tale, we learn of a man who was devastated when his story fell to pieces. I can tell you that as a charter member of River of Grass, I've experienced that feeling. We had a story. It was a beautiful story. It was held together by our imaginations, which wove a tapestry that included a sprawling campus of sanctuary and gardens with room to grow into a spiritual home for every soon to be realized Unitarian Universalist south of Lake Okeechobee. It wasn't a small story. And we didn't expect it to fall to pieces, but it did. And we picked up those pieces, dusted them off, and put them back together again a little differently each time, for the story broke often. Let me share it with you in case you don't know it or have forgotten. The story of River of Grass began in the imaginations of a few members of the Unitarian Universalist Church of Fort Lauderdale. You see, Western Broward County was growing, and for many, the travel time to the nearest UU home kept them from participating fully. This was unfortunate. Fortunately, we found a place to start at the Weston Community Center, where we set up shop each Sunday, heard our new minister preach, and grew our membership. Unfortunately, the kids met in the empty restaurant space. No chairs and a little smelly. But fortunately, we found a warehouse space that had been housing a fire station and converted it into a more permanent home where we grew our membership to more than 150. Unfortunately, although there was plenty of classroom space, there was no playground. This wasn't a permanent solution either, and we were feeling the pinch of our limited space. Fortunately, a small group of dedicated members searched and found a beautiful piece of property in Southwest Ranches. It took some persuading of the town council to change the zoning, but it came with a small house we converted into office and meeting space. Our story seemed to be unfolding just as we planned. We could see a growing sanctuary and room for kids to run and play. It was a very exciting time until an unfortunate thing happened. We learned that there was a drainage pond on the property which would prevent us from building the home of our dreams. Our story was falling to pieces. We would have to sell the property. Fortunately, our timing was just right, and we came out of that sale with a nice nest egg to put toward a future home. Our story was put back together, but it looked a little different. Now we were meeting in the cafeteria of Central Park Elementary School, where we finally had a playground for the kiddos. Unfortunately, as often happens, all of those big decisions left some too heartbroken to retain their membership. Our numbers and our income were dropping. We started using that nest egg to pay bills, so it too was sinking. Fortunately, we're a smart and resilient lot. We became creative, made some hard decisions, and said goodbye to our second settled minister. We found a beautiful space on State Road 84 to create a sanctuary all our own again. And soon our beloved Rev Amy found her way to us. Unfortunately, although it was a beautiful sanctuary, our kiddos lost classroom space and a playground. The rent was growing and our budget was feeling it. Fortunately, we started a capital campaign, which gave us the ability to see a new home on the horizon, one that included a sprawling campus of sanctuary and gardens with room to grow into a spiritual home for every soon to be realized Unitarian Universalist south of Lake Okeechobee. We know what comes next. Our story fell to pieces again. A pandemic of all things uprooted the plan. Or did it speed up the plan? Was there some fortunate in the unfortunate? It's still too soon to tell. The vows we've made with each other have broken 1,000 times. And yet we come, yet again. This is our story. If we've learned anything during these stay-at-home times, it's that we are smart and resilient. This past year, there has been no playground and no cookies. Yet our children, our teens, our families continue to come to find community online and grow their faith and their connections to each other. I dare say some of it has been really fun. We watched videos every week. We lit chalices and sang songs and played games, and we learned so much about how to be anti-racist. We've also learned how to play kazoos and how to make a holiday pageant through Zoom. Our amazing and dedicated teachers have learned to manage a Zoom room with aplomb and demonstrate crafts and science activities over a screen. We've had 5 new families join our classes because the information is rich and our teachers are smart, resilient, and kind. To be fair, this past year was also scary and lonely and sad, full of uncertainties and disappointments. Some of our families have not wanted to or couldn't possibly get their kids to sit in front of a screen on Sunday afternoons. I get that. We've missed them. Still, our story continues. It is precious and it is always incomplete. We need not hold it too close though, because we have learned that it's not as fragile as we may have once thought, and it is supported by a smart, resilient, and kind community. I honestly don't know what our faith development program will look like next year. I know there'll be kids and teachers and fun and learning. I know the folks at Soul Matters are including material about dismantling white supremacy culture and realizing our proposed eighth principle into every lesson. But I hesitate to get too attached to a plan just yet. I'm trying to learn from the wise words of Adrienne Marie Brown when she says, I've been reflecting a lot lately on how I don't trust people with agendas, master plans. I think of those people as trying to create a new story for others, placing a massive end on the story, a period that only they can see. For me, storytelling is an emergent process, a pollination-style intimacy where the results can't be fully predicted as the conditions shift. In my experience, the best storytelling is the best organizing. It's rooted in a truth people have experienced, has some magic in it, and something to long for, and a moment of beauty. But it is co-created as it is lived. No one can see the end of it. That allows people to stay in the present moment and attend to the work before them with intention, seeing the story unfold with themselves in it, rather than directed with themselves just outside the frame. My friends, ours is no caravan of despair. We are smart, we are resilient, we are kind to one another as our story unfolds as it will. When we tell the story of now, when our children tell the story of now, let's hope they remember the fortunate parts and share the wisdom gained from the unfortunate parts. Will we one day have a sprawling campus of sanctuary and gardens with room to grow into a spiritual home for every soon-to-be-realized Unitarian Universalist south of Lake Okeechobee? Maybe. It's certainly something to long for. And when that piece of the story unfolds, I want to be ready.
Spirit get low, Lord. Spirit get low, Lord. Spirit get low, Lord. May the light around us guide our footsteps and hold us fast to the best and most righteous that we seek. May the darkness around us nurture our dreams and give us rest so that we may give ourselves to the work of our world. Let us seek to remember the wholeness of our lives, the weaving of light and shadow in the great and astonishing dance in which we move.
What?
All y'all that make our faith development program go, Karen and our teachers and our families who continue to come in whatever condition they may be and bring their hearts into the gathering. I'd like to thank everyone who makes it possible for us to come as we are, though we've broken our vows 1,000 times. That we may celebrate the fortunate, learn from the unfortunate, and realize how very, very fortunate we are to travel this journey together. Again and again and again, no matter what. Till we meet again, shine.
Shine on.
Let's have some gallery view here so we can see some beautiful faces. Erin, thank you for putting all our bubble blowers together in that video and wrangling. This was our first really long distance video because Louisa lives in Massachusetts. So we thank her also for joining among us, and now you may see her more often. We hope so. So thanks for making that work. Erin, Rebecca, thank you for making the kazoo band work. When I got to a point, I didn't know what to do next. Thank you so much.
So, Rebbe, this is apparently a surprise for you as well, but we have a surprise for Karen, and Diane is going to talk about it.
All right.
I love this outside.
Can you leave your screen and come outside with me?
Okay.
I feel like a little kid.
I don't know what's happening here, Gary. Oh.
Oh. Look. It's Harper. Thank you.
It's Harper.
It's Harper.
It's Harper.
Yeah, lovely. Thank you. I love them.
Okay, I think now it's all time right, for enough. Coffee hour.
Enough.
Explain Harper to those who don't know.
So you may have noticed in one of the videos today, there was a little stuffed heron. That heron's name is Harper, and Harper has been spending time with all of our children this year. So, because Harper lost their home as well, so our kids have been taking Harper in 1 month at a time and caring for them. So, this is lovely. Thank you.
A Harper for your garden. Awesome.